you're going to be working with George Duke again. I mean, come on, you know, I mean, yeah.
George is not just a great arranger and keyboard player, he's the greatest singer. I love the way he sings and the way he writes. We used to write together, and he was in my very first 6 or 7 records, and I was in his few first records. And our children now have a band again.
Yeah.
So it's like that's the
that's
extent of our friendship.
Yeah.
We would call each other. He was in the West Coast, and I was in New York. And he said, "That line, why don't you do a little thing like this?" And this is all over the phone.
Yeah.
There was no computers, no Skype, no nothing.
Mm.
And okay, let me work on it.
Yeah.
And I'll send you a cassette then,
mm-hmm.
and you tell me what you think about it.
Yeah.
That was how we did work together.
He made the most amazing arrangements on your material, and of course, Billy Vera Cruz. People are just so sick of me talking about Billy Vera Cruz. but he was just really just
George
amazing.
Is unique. One of my favorite records of George's Brazilian Love Affair.
Your Brazilian Sugar?
It's so swing.
Just so beautiful.
And my favorite Wayne Shorter's record is Native Dance.
Oh, Milton. From the Lonely Afternoon.
Yeah.
It's just
exactly.
Yeah, that's as I said before, whenever you do a version of a song, you just do it completely differently.
I do it
my way.
Because I mean, it's like classical music. Most of classical musicians play over and over the same composers.
Mm.
So how do you know the difference?
Yeah.
It's on the interpretation.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's how you phrase it. It's the dynamics you use.
Yeah.
And how important is one passage compared to another passage.
Yeah.
And that's, I think that's what helps me
mm-hmm.
in my own limitations, because I don't have 6 octaves anymore.
Yeah.
I have 4, which is pretty good still.
You still hit the notes?
Notes when I have to, but I have a trumpet player here or a saxophone player there.
Mm-hmm.
And José also double me.
Yeah.
We use some of our knowledge that we acquire through the years.
Mm-hmm.
But I feel that there's a new generation of great musicians coming right now. From this year on, you should check everybody new right now.
Yeah.
And I'm right now I'm in love with Jamie Cullum.
Oh, Jamie. Yeah.
And he sat in with us and with the CTI All-Star Band, and he shook everybody's hand and
mm-hmm.
he came to me and kissed me and said, "I used to come and see you at Ronnie's
mm-hmm.
4 or 5 times when I was very young."
Yeah.
I said, "You're kidding me." I'm waiting till I tell my kids, because they are all hooked on Jamie. You know?
Yeah.
And,
that's cool, because I remember when Tanya was performing with Zach Marmon at the North Sea, and he was coming on next, and backstage it must have been about 25 of us, and he went up to each one of us and shook our hand. So polite, I must say, very, very polite.
And funny guy too, he's a funny guy.
Mm.
He's a kid, he's Peter Pan, he's, I don't know, and he can sing, and most amazing, he can play the
He's passionate run. About his music. He's passionate about his music, you know?
Yeah.
And so what's the next chapter for you? I know obviously you're looking to make this Brazilian album, but where do you see your music going?
Or
you're just going to go with the flow?
I don't see the end of it, but I see the light at the end of the tunnel.
Okay.
So I'm just walking towards that.
Yeah.
And once I am out of the tunnel, and I begin the album, then it will take a life of its own.
Yeah.
That's what usually happens. After every song starts to grow, and suddenly somebody else that was not supposed to be in there comes in and say, check this song out. And it happens to be the one song that makes the album famous.
Listen, Flora, we're going to wrap it up there, but you know I'm going to ask you, you have to give me Line of Vera Cruz.
Oh,
please,
you've
got to give me Line of Vera Cruz. Line.
Line. Ah, quisera encontrar a moça que se foi no mar de Vera Cruz, do pranto que ficou, do norte que sonhei, das coisas de lugar.
Oh, you are such a darling.
Sim,
Flora Purim, the one, the only. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Really appreciate this.
It was.
Wow, you're watching us here.
Yeah, this is for the bloopers.
But
Seymour, tell her the story. Tell her the story.
Has a broken leg, so we decided to sit in the hotel room bed, which is very unusual for an interview.
It's not in bed with Madonna, it's in bed with Flora. That's what this is.
It's gonna be the title.
Yeah, in bed with Flora. That's what we call it.
Thank you very much.
And yeah, thank you. Much love and appreciation.